Graders, it's Mrs. Reed again. Looking forward to sharing the slides with you today as we go through the lesson. Hello, Super Sixth Graders. Today is April 21st, 2020, and we will learn more about the Aztec civilization. Hope you are all doing well, and I really miss you. If we were in the classroom, we'd do a little mini lesson on listening, so I have a couple quotes there. The quieter you become, the more you can hear. Remember earlier in the year, we worked a little bit on the act of listening and how good it felt for somebody to give you their full attention, not to be distracted. Hopefully we have more time for that now, and that's happening in our families, and how good it feels also to give somebody our full attention. Courage is what it takes to stand up and speak. Courage is also what it takes to sit down and to listen. It's a big part of kind of helping and learning from each other. Here is the astounding Aztecs, the famous Aztec calendar stone. We're gonna talk about the Aztec calendar today. I believe it's in a museum in Mexico City. It might be in Spain because they took a lot of artifacts back. As you go through the slides, please review and study this chart. You should have copied it down and sent me a picture of it. Make sure if you haven't that you do that yet. But if you've already sent the picture, you don't need to copy it again. But read through it, study it, focus in on keywords. If you want to write it again, it's just good practice for remembering it. Make sure you listen to the song again. Listen for the information and what they're teaching you. That first picture is a picture of the capital city, Tenochtitlan, and that they built because they, legend has it, the Aztecs were looking for a place where a hawk was holding a snake, and it happened, I think, at the top of a cactus, and it happened on the island, Tenochtitlan. And they used that, and they expanded that island by building the chinampas, the floating gardens. They would dig up the dirt from the bottom of the lake. It was a shallow kind of swampy lake. Most of the lake has dried up or been filled in, and that's where Mexico City is today. So this is a slide. This is from the Aztec magazine. If we were in the classroom, I have Discovery magazines that we read every year. I just have a few pictures from it and highlights that you can read through as best you can. I know they're not perfectly clear, but I put some captions on the side that are really important for you to understand and for you to know kind of how those cities were laid out. What was important. An Aztec warrior was often sent to fight enemy tribes. The Aztecs had a lot of enemies, and that's what, when the Spanish arrived, Cortez is going to use some of the enemy tribes to help capture the Aztec, including some of the smaller Mayan villages they had spread out. The Mayans are still there, but they weren't in their big civilizations, their big cities like Chichen Itza. They had abandoned their cities and were spread out into the jungle in smaller tribes. They had two calendars, so read carefully, get the description. The solar calendar is about the movement around the sun, so 365 days. Probably that traveled from the Mayans through different tribes, and the Aztec kind of adopted that, what was in the area already. And then the sacred calendar was from their religion. In between the Mayans and the Aztec, there was a violent tribe, the Toltecs, and that was in one of the videos that moved through there, and they kind of brought the sacrifices. Mayans had some human sacrifice, but they're not as known, and I don't think it was as common. It was a more rare event. In Aztec life, because they adopted this different religion, they really felt they had to do it more often to make the harvest happen. They didn't have the science to understand how nature worked. And so they relied on what the priest told them in this religion, that they felt they had to do that for everybody to survive. Here's about Xochimilco is the national park in Mexico City. It's a World Heritage Park that still lets you see some of the chinampas. So there are areas in Mexico City where there are still canals around where they built, and you can see how the roots go down through the islands. They would weave the reed mats, go down to the bottom of the lake and scoop up with their hands. They didn't have any tools. Well, maybe they had some kind of clay pots or something, but they would bring it back up and put it on top of those. So very simple, from very simple. They didn't have any mechanicals, machines like we would have now, or bulldozers to do that. Also, here's where they talk about chocolate. When the Spanish arrive, one of the first things that Cortez is going to get when he meets Montezuma, that's a very important meeting, and it very changes the world. Again, it's East meet West, the two continents coming together, like when we talked about the Vikings meeting the natives. And when Cortez meets Montezuma, they present him with a drink that's like hot cocoa. It's the cacao or cocoa bean ground up into a powder, but they would put chili powder into it, so it would be spicy. and kind of bitter tasting. It didn't have the sugar and it didn't have the milk like our milk chocolate does now. So it probably tasted nothing like, it's more like baking chocolate that wouldn't have the sugar in it. Tlachtli was their ball game. Very difficult, very challenging. It was kind of prep. Sometimes they would capture and their enemies would play and they'd be fighting for their life. They'd be playing for their life. If they lost, they might be the ones to be sacrificed, to be offered to the gods to make sure that the harvest would grow. Just more about, make sure you read these slides as you go through the slides when you're done with the video. Just read them carefully, write down some notes that you're going to remember. Chinapas are the artificial islands. They're rich soil dug out of the lake beds. And they were big, maybe a football or two football field size. They would have their house on it and they would plant their gardens to grow food and to trade their food and pay their tribute. And then this is a little bit about that legend, why they picked the in the lake for Tenochtitlan. The legend said they were looking for an eagle would be holding a snake. And they use that legend today. So you see the Aztec heritage on Mexico's flag today. It's the symbol in the middle of their flag, and that's from their Aztec heritage. They're very proud of it. So you're going to watch this movie, take some notes. Please send me a picture. This can be on the back of your Aztec chart that you already copied down, or if you wrote some notes today, just send me a picture of those notes you're taking. And then there is a check-in today, so you'll click on the link. This is an active link. It's also in the agenda on the website. And it's just a few questions to answer about the Aztec. And you can look back at your note chart to help you. You can look back at the slides if you need. I hope you guys have a great day. I miss you guys. Take care.